Now, when I started with my first podcast, I took 100 of retakes because I have written the script. I just need to read that. But I took 100 of retakes. But then I told Noah, reading is not something which I need to present. Then eventually I started like, कुछ भी मन में आता था रिगार्डिंग माई नॉलेज और एक्सपीरियंस आई यूज टू शेयर एंड नाउ टूडे लाइक कभी भी ओपन करके बकवास करके ओवर.
Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of the Jai Thakur Show. Today we have an incredible personality, Miss Khushi. She has been awarded with 3 world records. One is Star Book of World Records, Vajra Book of World Records and UK Books of Record. And she has been invited as TEDx speaker. She is an entrepreneur, writer, author, digital creator, public speaker, socialpreneur, NC certified investor and much more. So first of all, I'm really honored to have you on the show, ma'am.
Thank you so much. It was a great, you know, introduction for me. Anyone can give.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah. So first of all, please tell us about this journey of world records, how it began and how it's how has it changed your life?
See, I would just start from the scratch, from where I was. Sure. I was in the depression phase and then I came off and then just awarded with the world record. Actually, I was in the class 11th and my friends were separated through various college cities and the various fields. So we had a group of 10 friends in the class 10th and we all separated in class 11th. So I was in the science and my friends were in the commerce. So like, okay, then days passed. So there was one friend of mine, best friend of mine. We were best friends since class 9th. So what he did, I don't know why, what happened, he betrayed me. In the 11th class, he betrayed me. He betrayed me. Then the thing happened, he started leg pulling me. He started to make a fun of me. Like he started every nuisance creativity, what he can do. Now in our school, the strength was low. So we were around 20 people, including Max, Commerce and Science. So all the students, all the 19 to 18 students were by his side because the way he used to tease me was actually a fun. So like all the people were by his side and I was too alone in the 11th class. And like my seniors were there, they also asked me what happened, why you are roaming alone, why you are just having your everything alone. So I don't like to indulge with them. So I don't want to create a nuisance. I don't want to create a scene in front of my seniors. Then days passed, he continued his thing. Like I was so devastated that time, like it was a completely a depression phase for me. Like I just can't put it into the words like what I was going through that time. And the worst part was I can't even tell my teachers and parents because I don't want to get involved in this because this was my matter and this was just a friendship matter, so I don't want to get them to involve in this. So like I go and talk to that person why I are doing like this. So he told ki I'll not stop, do whatever you want to do. Then again he started every time from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. our school timing. He used to completely disturbed me, irritated me. Now one fine day I thought of giving up. I just thought of like, no, it's not working out anymore. I don't want to just create all this nuisance in my head anymore. I'll just give up. Then I thought like, no, yaar, I'm doing it wrong. Why I'm just wasting my entire life, my entire deserving life for that one person who is teasing me. He was my best friend. Okay, he betrayed me. That's completely fine. But I'm just completing my most deserving life. So I explained myself. And next day, when I just went to school, I gave him a tight slap in front of teachers. And then I told, if you will continue this, then things are going to be worse for you. So he was like, what you will do. So I told, see, this is the 11th class. Next year, we'll be going to promote in 12th. And in 12th class, internal number are in the teacher's hand. And you know, teachers will listen to whom. So please be in your limits. अदरवाइज व्हाट आई विल डू यू जस्ट कांट इमेजिन. सो ही वाज स्कैर्ड फॉर दैट टाइम बिकॉज नो टीचर यूज टू लाइक हिम दैट पर्सन. सो स्लोली एंड स्टीडली ही जस्ट स्टॉप दैट थिंग. सो वन डे माई इंग्लिश टीचर टोल्ड मी दैट देर इज अ इंटर स्कूल डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन. डू यू वॉन्ट टू पार्टिसिपेट लाइक योर इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग स्किल्स आर गुड. सो आई टोल्ड यस मैम इट वुड बी अ ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर मी. सो आई वॉज वेरी नर्वस बिफोर द कॉम्पिटिशन. आई रोट द स्क्रिप्ट. द अनदर पर्सन द कलीग ऑफ मी शी हैज रिटन द स्क्रिप्ट फ्रॉम द मैम बट आई रोट माई सेल्फ. So I was very nervous, like what will happen. And when I came to the, and when I just went to the stage, now I just completely forgot what I have written, and I just went and said whatever in my mind and said that this that according to the topic. I started with the story, completed with the story, and then there I got a national level debater award.
Wow.
I was like yeah. What happened? I just completely forgot my script and I won the national level debater award. It was in ITM University. That's a university over here. So I was honored with the guest. The guests were very, very respectful person. Like they were aged and they were from some good reputed universities. They have came from outside actually.
Oh, wow.
So after that, I gained a confidence, know that I can do something. Like if I have a potential of doing something, then I can do. But in that phase, when he used to tease me, when I was alone, I used to sit alone, I used to study alone, I used to eat alone, everything. So what I did, I started penning down my feelings, like what I feel in the form of shairis or poems. And when I just opened my notebook today, na, I feel like, yeah, what the thing I was writing, it is not at all matching. So slowly and steadily, I improved my writing as well. So that poems and that shairis were featured in Dainik Bhaskar.
Wow.
And the media reporter just approached me after that event, and that shairi and poem was featured in that. So I gained a more confidence. No, I can do something now. Then after 12th was like completely into boards thing. So I was just not concentrating this, all this nuisance and time. Then after completing my 12th, I thought now let's just concentrate on something because my college life is sorted. Let's just do something. So what I did, I started writing. And then again for the debate, I got featured in the Dainik Bhaskar and ET Times. It is the thing of last year only. Then I started writing down my book. When I started writing the book, I was so indulged into that book that day and night I used to write all the day. I was in the laptop, and within 48 hours, like within 40 to 42 hours, I remember, I just completed my book. And I was like, seriously, I completed the whole entire book in just 40 to 42 hours. And when I just contacted the publication house, they asked me when you started. Because when we start, the Wordpad shows the date when we start. So they told that you have started and you have completed in this. So they gave the name for the world records. So that world record people approached me that your world record is selected and you have been awarded with this Vajra world record. And then Star Book of World Record approached me, and then UK Book of World Record. Then I started the second book, which in this January only, 2021, Basics of Stock Market. And stock market is like something of my niche, something of my interest. So I was like just writing. And I remember in 24 to 28 hours, hardly 24 hours, I completed that book as well. And then again, these people reached.
Great. So my question is that how, like you said you were a science student. So from science, how have your interest shifted to stock market and entrepreneurship?
Actually, like when everyone were in the lockdown last year. So I used to, I was like sitting idly and online class to koi attend hi nahi karta, to be very honest. So my interest, when I explored myself, my interest straight away moved towards the markets and the entrepreneurship. And my family background is business. Like my father, when he used to discuss any business kind of purpose with my mother and my brother. So I used to give him suggestions and then he used to implement. So the base is my family, like from a family background, I just built a strong knowledge and the strong communication with this business. And for the stock markets, none of us in my entire family, in my relatives, none of us is investing in stock markets unless me. because I'm the only child that I'm investing in stock market. So like my interest went towards the stock market. So I didn't know anything about it. And when I just opened this books, I ordered Rich Dad Poor Dad because I have heard about it. So when I was just turning the pages, and it is like what it is written, I don't know about NSE and BSE basic things. And then I started watching YouTube contents. And then slowly and steadily with YouTube contents, I just jumped into the books like that. Then books gave me the strong knowledge about the markets. And then I started with this NSE Academy. Then I gave the exam and I cleared with 80% because NSE has a criteria. If you just clear the exam with 80 or more than 80%, so then only you will get the NSE certification. Then only you will be recognized as an NSE certified investor. If you have 79% as well, you will not recognize. So I worked hard. So I cleared the exam. So this was the from a non-financial background to financial background as a
great, great. So what's your age right now? I feel you might be in first year of your college.
19.
Wow. Yeah. Great. It's really great that by the age of 19, because I had a podcast with Abhishek Jain, who by the age of 19 have already given two to three TEDx speech, and he was also a big entrepreneur. He started from the age of 16. So I'm really amazed by the people, like, because even I am 19, but I haven't done anything big yet.
You are doing that. Great, the Jay Thakkar show, and that is most appreciated show.
Thank you. From this financial background to book writing to world records, how have you shifted to particular entrepreneurship? Like, you're founder of DGX Lands company. So what's that company and what's the idea behind that?
Okay, so Digi Excellence is basically a digital marketing and influencer marketing company. When I was I'm a content writer, freelance content writer as well. So when I was working as a freelance content writer in the digital marketing room, so I was like world is so much digitally accused that we just can't think of offline as well. So from there, I built an idea. I contacted one of my friend that I'm starting Digi Excellence. This is the idea behind it. So do you want to join in? So he first laughed, no, digital marketing, there are thousands and thousands of digital marketing agencies, so no, I'm not interested. So I thought it's okay. He was a very good friend of mine. Like, we discussed 2-3 days back that if we are going to have a startup idea. So just after that call disconnected, I had an idea of this influencer marketing with digital marketing. We create influencers with digital marketing to promote both of them. So he told no, I'm not interested. So I told okay, I'll just alone start with this. So I started with this. I first made the Instagram handle of this, then website, then finding the clients. Finding the clients was the most toughest part which I faced, because I have to reach 100 of people, and out of 100 only one used to reply, and then again next week 100 of people, then only one used to reply. So that was the tough part, but okay, nothing comes easy, because if you are having a struggle phase.
I can completely feel that, because I started my podcast in 2020, and even I was approaching guests. So like, till now, I have approached around 3,500 guests, and from that, we are having just in audio platforms, it's just 30 podcasts, and on YouTube and video format, it's about 25, 26 episodes. So,
that's
like,
great.
You
that's
can just
great.
Imagine from 35,000 people, only these many people agreed, and I was able to bring only these many people on board. So, I can completely understand that, how that rejection would have faced.
Just make a point sure that the people who are just rejecting you today now will find you the way to connect with you, like, please let us feature in your show, and then you will show their true colors, you know, like, they are rejecting you today, but they will just find you over Instagram or over LinkedIn, that where's this Jay or where's this Kushi, we need to get featured with these people, and we have to work hard for this day.
True, 100%. I have what how can I articulate it? I don't know, or I don't want to, always warn people. I had this experience and this like similar experience. My first podcast with was Mr. Rojas Rao, who is a TV actor, Bollywood and local film industry actor. I had him as my first guest, and there was one of my old classmate who never used to talk to me. And then next day, when I was about to when I started promoting it through posters and all, so he DM'd me on Instagram that, "Hey bro, share me your poster. I also want to share it." So I know how these kind of people, and I have seen that some people reject you just on basis of your numbers, that, "Okay, you don't have numbers, I won't like to come to you." I'm like, I don't have numbers because I have just began. If you come, who knows that we both might blow up the algorithm, and we both might go viral. Who knows? But then there are people who has this problem, "No, you'd have less numbers. I am big personality. I don't go with lesser number than these." So I'm like, it's okay, no issues for that.
Exactly the same. When I started with my YouTube journey in May, this May only, so I have only 30 number of subscribers till now in this 1 month, because in between I was very inconsistent, because actually I lost my grandfather. So for 15 to 20 days I was not able to shoot or something like that. So this reducing this 20 days, I just post content consistently. Like if I decided to post on Tuesday and Saturday, no matter what, if I have 2 subscribers or 3 subscribers, I will post content for those 3 subscribers, because one day that 3 subscribers will turn into 3 million, and we have to work hard, because initial days for each and every one of us is a rough phase. Even the stronger billionaires today, Mr. Ratan Tata and Mr. Elon Musk, if we say, they also had started from the scratch, and they are today in the wind. So this is the scratch period for us, and we have to stop till the wind, till then
True,
struggle.
100%, 100%. And also with this struggle, we need to I personally feel this, that we need to bring on more opportunities with us, because those are the only steps which can help us grow from scratch or struggle to something little bigger than that. And I think for me, what has worked for me is Scenes by Avalon, because like we had a conversation on that regarding Scenes by Avalon. Because what happened with me is, when I used to do this YouTube, I had good guests, I had good content, but I was not having good audience for that. Like for me, my audience were my old schoolmates and my juniors. My major audience was that, because those were the only connection I had in beginning. So like there was nothing more to that. Like people were like, "Okay, come. He's our senior, or he was a classmate, so go give like and all that." But there was no person to consume the content and understand it and give a feedback on basis of content, not just like, "तू हमारी स्कूल का है तो कर दिया," in that sense. So now when I started Scenes by Avalon in April, there I started getting good audience, the audience which actually you want to consume my content, who want to consume the podcast I produce, the content I provide on that platform. So like, what according to you, which platforms has worked for you, or which platforms are you strategizing to work upon?
Okay, so basically I was having no idea of just expanding myself as a digital creator. I was just using this Instagram by watching these reels and exhausting my daily data. So what I did now, I thought, now I have this qualification, let's just make it, expand it till this. So I started making content on YouTube. I started podcast. I started my own podcast. Actually, me and my friend, one of my friend, we have an Instagram page over there, the FinKit, and I post content because her internship is going on, and as soon as she will complete the internship, she will join us. So we both will start the content creation in the one video, but till now I'm just creating alone. So, and for Avalon, like you told, now in the Avalon, what I did, I started Avalon in May. and after, you know, after the day one of joining, the next day I was not well. Then after 2-3 days, this a scenario happened of my grandfather, so I just stopped there. But then when I was consistent after a few days, now then I growed with an organic audience. Now people are approaching me in the Instagram, like, we want to connect with you. Now I'm highly active on each and every social media platform, like whether it's LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, or Avalon, Tag Mango, YouTube, every, because I have planned things for me, because daily I have to post one reel over Instagram. Tuesday and Saturday I'll be posting one content on YouTube, podcast every alternative, Twitter every alternative, and LinkedIn, if I like something, I'll just post it on LinkedIn. And in Tag Mango, there's nothing like posting kind of scene. You just need, the clients just need to book the slots which we have provided. So I just go and check on like which client has approved or which client has not. So I just keep modifying the description of it. So it is like we need to strategically plan everything for our each and every social media platform, because many people think multitasking, like if you do many things at a time, you'll end up doing nothing. And that is completely a myth. That is completely a myth. I study, I write content, I do internships, I make content, I speak, I do everything in 24 hours. And that is a myth. But you just need to strategically plan everything for you. Like in the morning, it's your me time. Please give your me time, because after me time, you'll feel more energetic. My me time is 6 to 7, because I just go up in my terrace with my earphones on and just I wind breezes and I enjoy there. And after that, when I came down to my room, I have session on Avalon after just coming down from the terrace. So that is how you need to plan yourself.
True enough. True enough. Like people also ask me that, how do you do this many things? Because I do Avalon every alternate day. I'm going to start LinkedIn. I do counseling sessions. And that's for free of cost. So then I also do YouTube, my podcast. I do my university, like university studying. I'm starting my internships from 16th. I do internships. I also like sometimes do a little bit of freelancing for people. So people ask me that, how do you do these many things? I'm like, bro, just plan. Just plan it, you'll get it.
Planning is the real thing. You just we all have 24 hours. So now wasting 24 hours into that reel, instead of wasting that 24 hours, you can just consume that 24 hours into doing something valuable that will create some kind of value into your life, because that reels will not create value. You are watching reels that will create value to that person, not to you.
True. And so also do data
something for you. Yeah, data. Bahut reel mein bahut data jata. I'm much experienced in this.
True enough. Like for me, what I do is like, I don't have any specific planning for every day. Ye is time pe. Yeah, podcasts are planned. They are planned on time. They are scheduled every day and they're planned on time. But what's the major chunk which consumes my majority of the day is consultations and creating content for Avalon. Because what happens is like, for me, I'm doing free consultations. So like not major people are taking part in it. But what major problem I get is from my juniors about their relationships and all that. So I'm like, okay, now bring it on. I'll help you out with this. Then I'll go and find content for Avalon, because Avalon content is major time consuming, because it's 1 hour, it's raw. And also like bahut baar ye hota hai ki I'm walking on terrace, I'm doing my Avalon session, I am I'm in one room closed, I'm doing my Avalon session. I'm sitting somewhere and I'm doing my Avalon session. So there's no fixed like studio type thing to just go sit alone and do the sessions, and I have my whole script and planned everything. So I have to remember, I have to absorb content, because on Avalon for me, what happens is like, what I do, I share my small chunk of perspective, I take everyone's perspective, and then together we all come and solve and give a particular answer to that particular topic which we are having the session on. And after that, I have Q&A session. And Q&A session is majorly about problem solving. People ask the question that,
Exactly.
bhaiya, I have this problem. I have this problem. What to do? What not to do? So my major part goes in preparing for those solutions.
Same, yeah, because tomorrow I have a session on biological theories in stock market. Like I was studying, and from there I just take this concept that biological theories are related with stock markets, because Darwin has given major amount of theories and that was proved wrong and wrong and wrong. And same goes with the markets as well. Like there are many type of theories and that keeps on fluctuating the day by. So like for the creation of now, I just can't explain this one line theory, because Darwin has given this one line theory, which is written in the book. And now we have one line theory for the stock market. So we need to research deep down in that topic. And I totally agree for this Avalon, because we just can't present the scripted. But for the podcast, what we can do, we can just write 2-3 pages and we can just read on. But for the Avalon, we just need to interact with the live audience. So that is not possible. Now, when I started with my first podcast, I took 100 of retakes, because I have written the script. I just need to read that. But I took 100 of retakes. But then I told, no, yeah, reading is not something which I need to present. Then eventually I started like, कुछ भी मन में आता था regarding my knowledge or experience, I used to share. And now today, like कभी भी ओपन करके बकवास करके
ट्रू 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 इनफ लाइक फॉर मी पॉडकास्ट हैज बीन डिफरेंट लाइक इनिशियली आई यूज्ड टू लाइक यू नो प्लान क्वेश्चंस आई यूज्ड टू प्लान दिस ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 बट देन इवन आई वाज नॉट एंजॉयिंग इट एंड नॉर माय गेस्ट यूज्ड टू एंजॉय इट मच दे वर एंजॉयिंग इट क्वेश्चंस वर लिटिल इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर देम बट आई वाज लाइक ओके लाइक ये क्वेश्चन तो मैं 15 मिनट में बना देता हूँ जब भी मैं सोचने बैठता हूँ सो लाइक व्हाई डोंट आई मेक इट अ मोर कॉन्वर्जेशन लाइक व्हाई डोंट आई ऑल्सो पुट माय शेयर ऑफ थिंग्स टू दिस पॉडकास्ट बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली होस्ट इज मी एंड आई एम जस्ट लाइक आई एम आस्किंग क्वेश्चन गेटिंग आंसर आस्किंग क्वेश्चन गेटिंग आंसर एंड दैट वॉज द होल पॉडकास्टिंग ऑफ माई थिंग इन इनिशियली बट नाउ आई एम लाइक ओके आई गेट द कॉन्सेप्ट आई गेट द थीम I study about the theme, I get the questions, I write down the questions, but then I just need one question to start the conversation. After that,
yeah,
the
exactly.
conversation is on me. Like whatever question comes in my mind rapidly, I'll ask them and I'll give my perspective to what I think. And then I'll take it as a whole conversation.
Yeah. Yeah, this is the fact, because when scripted thing, when we write 2-3 pages, that will end up in 2-3 minutes, but when we just add more values and when we just start interaction with each other, like 2 minutes when it will take into 2 hours will not get to know. And this is the
true
fact.
true enough. Like I had this podcast with Tariq Merchant, who is creating great science videos on Instagram, and I asked him that, sir, we'll be having this podcast, it will be about 40 to 45 minutes. And he was like, I'm little pessimistic about it. Like, will it take 20 minutes? You told that theme is this much and like you are going to talk this much about it. I'm like, yes, sir, it will happen. You just join, you'll enjoy it. And
yeah.
when I asked him that, okay, sir, we are ending here and how was this? So he was like, what's the time? I'm, sir, it's 40 minutes plus. So he was like, wow, I didn't knew it was 40 plus.
Yeah, this happened.
That's why we majorly have 1 hour conversation with our friends. Majorly.
Yeah, exactly. Because like we started with one topic and we end up with 10th topic, and in between these 9 topics we talk about anything. And we don't even know that don't even make sense as well. But we want to talk. Now there's
True.
My best friend. There's my best friend. Not that one. Okay. He's my very good friend. So like when I used to call him, like he used to ask like, ho gaya dinner, ho gaya, haan ho gaya, kya khai, ye khai, theek hai, now what you had, this, and then we'll start having this much amount of conversation, like he's in different college, I'm in different college, he'll tell about his friends, I don't even know his friends, he'll tell about this person did that thing, that person did that thing, they both are committed, they both are single, they both break the band, and I literally enjoy that conversation, okay, and I don't even know them, And but I enjoy that conversation. And when like one day he called me like, what are you doing? I was just nothing, laying down. So he told, okay, just let's have a conversation for 10 to 15 minutes. I'm not feeling good. And then 10 to 15 minutes went to 2 hours. And it's like, what's the time? I'm saying like, it's two. We are talking since 12 and I started for 10 to 15 minutes. And I know this is the power of me. I just inculcate people in the power of talking that I also just forget like, what's the time?
No, true, true, true. Like this conversation, na, like many people ask me ki yaar, how to start a conversation, and like how, you know, like people say like, bhaiya, I'm introvert, I don't know what to do, I don't know how to start talking to different people. I'm like, allow them to say, this is the only way. Like there's this phenomena, like if I allow you to say, you'll enjoy saying something. And after that, you will ask me a question, and I'll enjoy say something. And then when this initial stage or initial any initial level of, let's say, awkwardness goes away, when we both started say something, and then just conversation flips in flips in on its own. It goes on with its with its own speed.
Yeah. See, there's nothing like introvert or extrovert. We have given the tech to us. We have given the tech to the other person. Like he's talking much, so he's introvert. She's talking less, so sorry, he's talking much, so he's extrovert. She's talking less, so she's introvert. No, introvert are nothing. There are difference between introvert and shy people. Introvert are the one who are just extrovert in their groups, in their boundaries. If I am introvert and I am having 10 friends, I'll be like open with that 10 friends. But if the 11th person step in, I'll be like, okay, no. And shy people are like, they don't even like to talk with any one of them, whether they are it's friends, whether they're family or someone. So introvert and extrovert, according to me, it's a tag which we have given to ourselves to judge. Like if we are talking more,
True.
we are extrovert. If we are talking less, we are introvert. But there's nothing like that. We just need to vibe on with the people, with the things around us.
True. And this is like we are creating boxes. Like, okay, this
Yeah.
person I'll talk this to this person I will only talk about this topics. This person I will
Yeah,
only talk
same.
about these topics. And then some other random person comes in, and we have to create a new box. We get in that laziness कि यार इसके लिए कौन नया बॉक्स बनाए, कौन नए टॉपिक्स बनाए, या
एग्जैक्टली
इसके लिए कौन
एग्जैक्टली
पूरा बताए. बट जस्ट स्टार्ट कॉन्वर्सेशन, यूल गेट एवरीथिंग.
यू माइट बी नोइंग अबाउट दिस क्लब हाउस ऐप. ओके नाउ इफ आई एम जस्ट ज्वाइनिंग द क्लब हाउस, माई फ्रेंड्स कैन ज्वाइन, इवन लाइक माई कॉलेज फ्रेंड्स कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन, माई स्कूल फ्रेंड्स कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन. सो देर इज अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइंड, ही स्टार्टेड अ रूम, वी वर टॉकिंग एंड हिज कॉलेज फ्रेंड्स केम अप. सो आई वॉज लाइक आई वेंट ऑन म्यूट. सो दे वर टॉकिंग लाइक द यंगस्टर पीपल यूज टू टॉक लाइक, चल उधर चल के ये करके आते, उधर चल के ये करके आते. सो आई इंजॉयड दैट थिंग. सो आई जस्ट अनम्यूट माई सेल्फ एंड आई स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग विद देम. एंड विद इन 2 days वी आर जस्ट दैट फ्रेंड्स, म्यूचुअल फ्रेंड्स. वी हैव बिकम दैट गुड फ्रेंड्स दैट वी जस्ट कांट रेजिस्ट दैट वी हैवंट मीट इन ऑफलाइन. लाइक वी थिंक कि नहीं भाई, वी हैव मेट इन ऑफलाइन वन डे बिकॉज वी आर जस्ट मैचिंग आर वाइब. And I was like,
True.
yeah, it would be awkward because it's my friend's friend. So should I just unmute myself and go and talk? So it's like when they started talking the relatable things, now I was like, अरे हाँ भाई ऐसे होता है.
True,
And
true,
that is
true
the fact.
enough. Like
Yeah.
that is what we need to do when we actually need to face fears. This is nothing but a small amount of fear. कि मैं बोलू ना बोलू, दिस दैट, जस्ट गो एंड फेस इट, क्या ही हो जाएगा.
Exactly. What will happen? What will happen? The least thing, you will just ruin the things. What will happen? You have the next opportunity as well. So just see, first talk, first exam, first everything, that doesn't mean that it should be better. With time, slowly and steadily, you'll learn everything.
First, give your be always give your best, and like this is what is generally said in all books. Like, just
Yeah.
do the thing, and नेकी कर दरिया में डाल. This is what is generally said. Because if
Yeah.
you cannot give your best, then how can you expect something good? And
Exactly.
also like तुम उस गलत होने की डर की वजह से अपना बेस्ट छुपा क्यों रहे हो, अपना बेस्ट दे क्यों नहीं रहे? व्हाई आर यू फियरिंग दैट कि ये होगा, ये नहीं होगा, वो होगा, ये नहीं होगा? आई एम जस्ट गो एंड सी क्या होगा. तुम बिना लाइक विदाउट टेस्टिंग द सॉल्ट, हाउ कैन यू से दैट दिस इज, विदाउट ड्रिंकिंग द वॉटर, हाउ कैन यू से दैट दिस इज टू सॉल्टी और दिस इज टू शुगरी? यू हैव टू ड्रिंक द वॉटर टू गिव द टेस्ट.
Now this same thing is written in the one of the best book which I ever read is Bhagavad Gita. Like in Bhagavad Gita, what Arjun used to say, like I don't want to fight. They are my family members. I just can't fight. So Shri Krishna used to say, देखो, you have to fight. ठीक है, you are facing fear. You know that these people are wrong. They are wrong, but you are facing because they are your relatives. You don't have to face this fear. You have to just outcome this fear and go and fight with them because that is for your wish, that is for your wealth. You don't have to think out of the box like these are my parents or these are my grandparents. I'm feared of facing my grandparents. You have to just cut off that fear. And this was the most beautiful line of Bhagavad Gita, which is written in chapter 13. And this is most relatable in our life as well. If we have fear of something, we are already in the outcome process. Like if we start something, for an example, if I start a startup, I'm like, what if the startup fails? What if the startup will not work out? What if people will not download my app? I'm already in the outcome process. I haven't started with the website yet. And I'm already in the outcome process. And that is the thing where 99% people fail to start up. Like not start up, like 99% people just don't think of starting off with anything. They're already in the outcome process. No, this will happen. This will surely happen. They have done the Bhavishyavani.
True, 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 100%. So what will be your top five books recommendations to people in general, if they want to go for stock market, a normal mindset type
Self-help books,
books,
yeah.
self help books, entrepreneurship, writing, book writing, and investment. So what will be your top
Yeah.
books for them?
So first is the best book for investing. You can go for The Intelligent Investor. Rich Dad Poor Dad is good, but The Intelligent Investor is the best book by Peter Lynch. And for self-help books, I would recommend you to go for The Power of Subconscious Mind because that is the book which changed my entire life. Because that book says if you wish of if you have desire of doing something, then you can do. You know, in Om Shanti Om movie, Shahrukh Khan has told that किसी चीज को किसी शिद्दत से चाहो तो पूरी कायनात तुम्हें उसे मिलाने के पीछे पड़ जाती है. सो आई वॉज लाइक वॉट द स्टुपिड लाइन दिस इज, बट ग्रैटिट्यूड एंड मैनिफेस्टेशन, दिस बोथ हैव द पावर टू टर्न योर ड्रीम्स इन टू रियालिटी. यू जस्ट एक्सप्रेस द ग्रैटिट्यूड.
True.
द थर्ड आई वुड लाइक टू सजेस्ट इकिगाई, दैट इज द बेस्ट बुक, इकिगाई. फोर्थ is 0 to 1, that is completely on startups. And fifth is The Power of Not Giving a Fuck, and that is the best book. Like it helps you to maintain your lifestyle. It helps you to maintain yourself in front of society. After reading this book, you'll not care about what the other people is saying about you. You'll just say go and fuck off. And that is it is written with the practical examples as well.
True, true.
And that is the five top five books you can recommend for your overall growth.
Great, great. Tomorrow I have the session on Avalon. Tomorrow, like this podcast is way too late, but will be uploaded a little later. But for you, tomorrow I'm having my session on Scenes by Avalon, which where the topic is manifestation exposed. So we'll be
Okay.
digging deep into the manifestation, how
Yeah.
manifestation works, how can you use it, what are the principles behind it, and why people are selling manifestation rather than making people understand manifestation. So we'll be
Yeah.
having this whole concept covered in that session of Avalon.
I know a numerologist. She is my mother's friend, actually. Like we have a very good connection with them. So she used to send some kind of manifestation tricks to my mom's in WhatsApp. One day when I was scrolling her WhatsApp, like I thought, like what this Neelam aunty has said, and it is the list of this 369. if you like, she has written in the Hindi, like, try my mother's name is Bhavna. Okay, so she written in Hindi, Bhavna isko try karna, this is very powerful. Theek hai? So my mom came to me, like, she asked, like, what it is written, it is written in this much long paragraph, what is manifestation? And it was written, if you wish to desire of something, write that 3 times. If you like, and the 6 times you have to write that I got that thing, and again 9 times you have to write your wish. So in this way you'll just come up with the manifestation. So my mom told, is it a true? So like, I'm being a science student, she asked very logical questions to me. So I told mama, see, writing, if it would have been the true thing, then like everyone would have written, like, 3 baar likh liya, meko aaj 1 crore mil jaye, meko mil gaye, fir likh liya, to have get the 1 crore in their bank account. It is not like that. Manifestation is something you are expressing your gratitude towards the universe. Okay? That you do every morning and every night before the bed. So you are okay now. Okay? This is a fact. If you want to try, you can try. But manifestation is not something writing and getting the things into your pockets. Manifestation is something when you just try and express your gratitude towards the powerful energies, towards the universe, towards your God, or towards anyone. Because when we buy, I have a habit, if I buy something from a vendor, from a local vendor, from a shopkeeper, I just say thank you. And the smile when they give out while saying the welcome, na, it is overwhelming, seriously.
True.
Like, I just say thank you to a sabji wala bhaiya, and he's like, thank you, welcome. And it's like, he also feels good when we just express our
True.
Gratitude towards him.
True, 100%. Like, see, writing and all, it can be a trick. Like, manifestation is a whole concept. To achieve it, there are millions and millions of tricks. And which trick works for you is you have to understand by being more self-aware, not just by following any trick ki 9 baar likh liya, 10 baar likh liya ho jayega.
Yeah, same. Exactly.
How was this whole podcast? Do you have any suggestions? Do you have any questions? How was this whole?
To be very honest, I don't have any suggestions, because perfect things doesn't require any suggestions. And I literally enjoyed, I don't know, like 30 to 40 minutes passed, and I literally enjoyed the whole session, answering your questions, interacting with you, like, because this is not something school class, like teacher is asking question, I'm giving the answers, then again teacher question number two, it will like recite an oral thing and I'll getting marks. Interacting section I like the most. Like when I used to give some kind of webinars, like last Sunday I was having webinar with a organization on mental health. So the people were like, ki they were not even answering. So I just summed up, because like when people don't interact now, I don't like just speaking and speaking. So I just cut off my parts and summed up in the shorter span of time, because they were not I'm asking, what is your favorite color? They are not unmuting themselves and saying, they are not even writing in the chat, apna favorite color to bata do, because I want to do that activity with you guys. No, usme se ek ne bola white, to main boli ab main kya karu. So interaction was very good with you, like we are meeting for the first time, and literally I don't feel like that we are meeting for the first time. I think like we just do a call on a regular basis and talk. So it was a great talking with you. It was a great podcast. I don't have any suggestions, because it was perfect. Keep going. And I just want to say that by the end of this week, by the end of this year, you'll grow, like you will be having a verified account in your Instagram or YouTube podcast.
Hey,
you'll
you so
grow
much.
Eventually.
Thank you so
you will grow like harder even.
Thank you so much. That's so sweet of you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I wish that happens. And by that time also, we will have few more podcasts uploaded.
Exactly. Yeah, sure.
Sure. Thank you so much for joining in.
Yeah.
And thank you so much
thank
for
you so
tuning
much
in.
For having me on board.
It's my pleasure and honor to have a person who by the age of 19 has 3 world records. It's my honor to have you on the show. So
it was great talking to you, seriously.
Thank you so much for joining in, and let's have a few more conversations on the podcast.
Yeah, sure. I would be really happy.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Yeah, sure. Chalo, stay safe and keep hydrated.
Stay safe.